Now we turn to our last example of dynamic programming and consider the problem of finding shortest paths between all pairs of vertices in a graph. If you're rusty on ideas like paths and graphs or Dijkstra's algorithm, it might help to review these ideas before proceeding with this part of the lesson. Note that the idea of shortest is given in terms of weights or costs on the edges. These might be negative, so we don't refer to them as lengths or distances themselves to avoid confusion. But we retain the word shortest with regard to the path instead of saying lightest or cheapest. Unfortunately, the use of this mixed metaphor is standard.
We're given a graph G, and a weight is associated with every edge in the graph. And our goal is to find a shortest path between every pair U and V in the graph. That is to say, a path that minimizes the sum of the weights involved in the path. Note that the idea of shortest here is in terms of these weights. These weights might be negative, so we don't refer to them as lengths or distances to try to avoid confusion. But on the other hand, we still refer to the paths as shortest instead of saying lightest or cheapest. Unfortunately, the use of this mixed metaphor is standard. Recall that for the single source problem, where we want to figure out the shortest path from one vertex to all others, we can use Dijkstra's algorithm, which takes v times log v plus e time when used with a Fibonacci queue. But this algorithm requires that the weights all be non-negative, an assumption that we don't want to make. For graphs with negative weights, the standard single source solution is the Bellman-Ford algorithm, which takes order v times e time. Now we can run these algorithms multiple times, once with each vertex as the source. If we visualize the problem of finding the shortest path between all pairs as filling out a grid like this one, then Dijkstra or Bellman-Ford would correspond to filling out this one row at a time, one call to the algorithm to fill out one row of the table. This strategy involves running each of these algorithms v times, so we can just add a factor of v to their running times to get the all pairs shortest path version. Where the weights are non-negative, this strategy of using Dijkstra's algorithm is quite competitive. For the case where the weights could be negative, however, and especially when the graph is dense, we're looking at an algorithm that is on the order of v to the fourth for Bellman-Ford. Using dynamic programming, we're going to be able to do better.